Today, I'm going to be going to my first college soccer game in 2 years, as I'm going to be going down to Santa Clara University to watch Santa Clara Broncos versus Houston Baptist Huskies. Now, it is still relatively early in the college soccer season, and usually when we're this early into the college soccer season, that means that we have a lot of non-conference matchup, and this, of course, is one of them, with Santa Clara Broncos currently playing in the West Coast Conference and Houston Baptist currently playing in the Western Athletic Conference, also known as WAC. But in terms of this game, certainly the Broncos will be the favorites, as they have got off to a good start into their new season, winning 4 out of their first 5 games and only conceded 2 goals. Whereas for Houston Baptist, it hasn't been the best start from them, only winning 2 out of their first 6 games and have a record of 2-0-4. But yeah, let's see how this match is going to go, and let's see, maybe we potentially could see an upset in this one. Let's go soccer.
So I've just arrived here at Santa Clara University, and I'm now making my way to the stadium, which should be right around this building here. So I've just arrived inside the stadium, and as you can see, both teams are doing their pregame warm-up. I believe these are the Santa Clara Broncos player doing their pregame warm-up, and over there are the Houston Baptist player doing their pregame warm-up. And by the way, I actually got a ticket stub for this game, and with how everything is going digital and it's going mobile, I'm kind of surprised they still give me like ticket stuff.
So we got about 35 minutes before the beginning of this match, and since it's been such a long time, I have recorded a college soccer game in the Sporthop series episode. And for those of you that have just started watching my Sporthop series episode, I wanna just kind of explain some unique rules that is only found in college soccer and it's not found in other professional soccer games. So one of the unique rule is that in college soccer, you can actually have unlimited substitution, but the player that you actually subbed out, he can actually come back into the game once, and that's something you just do not find in any other soccer game, where, you know, even in some of those lower league where there's unlimited substitution, once you sub a player out, he cannot come back in. But in college soccer, that's a little bit different, where he can actually come back in one more time. The other unique rule is that there is actually no stoppage time in college soccer, and the clock actually does stop on the referee discretionary. Usually that happens when if there's an injury or if there is some deliberate time wasting by one of the team, and the referee can stop the clock, or after when a goal that is scored, the referee usually stop the clock until the game resumes. But the most unique rule about college soccer that is found only in this is the fact that if the game remains tied after 90 minutes, we don't actually end in a draw. We actually go into 2 10-minute extra time period, and those 2 10-minute extra time period are sudden death extra time period, where whoever scored the first goal will win the game. But if nobody scored the goal after the 2 10-minute extra time period, that's when the game determined as a draw. But yeah, that is pretty much some of the unique rules of college soccer. I mean, obviously some of those rules that I mentioned, I'm not really a big fan of, especially the extra time rule, where it's kind of weird the fact that they go to extra time, and the fact that you know, after the 2 minute of extra time period over, it ends in a draw, even though they could have just done that after the whole 90 minutes. But like I said, you know, we still got about 35 minutes before the kickoff of this game.
And now it looks like both team is making their way into the center circle. And in just a bit, we are going to be getting ready for the start of this college soccer game between Santa Clara Broncos and Houston Baptist Huskies. Cross comes in here, and it is going to be high, as, well, that was an early opportunity here from the host. Maybe get a breakthrough, as this is a long lofted in, and it is in the back of the net.
Well, the Broncos take the 1-0 lead as the fans here in the stands celebrate, and certainly the student section there on the other end. And really, that kind of just came out of nowhere, where it was a cross that was deflected, and it somehow found one of their player that just heads it fit in. And the Broncos takes a 1-0 lead.
the game where chances has been at a premium in this game.
Countdown is about to start here. Maybe one last opportunity here for Houston Baptist as they launch this one into the box, and it's going to go straight to the goalkeeper, and I think the keeper is just going to keep this ball in. And that is the halftime whistle. Halftime here in Santa Clara University. It's the host, Santa Clara Broncos, with a 1-0 lead over Houston Baptist Huskies.
So it's halftime here at Santa Clara University as it's the Santa Clara Broncos with a 1-0 lead over Houston Baptist Husky. And despite the fact that there's only two clips that I basically show in the first half, which just tells you that this first half has been a very uneventful and relatively boring game. We do have the opening goal of this game came in the 34th minute, and it was just kind of a ball kind of launch in that was actually deflected, and somehow in some way while the Broncos player was able to flick that one into the back net to get the opening goal of this game. But yeah, let's see how the second half is going to be. And obviously from what I saw here in the first half is that it seems like Houston Baptist is just kind of parking the bus, trying to maybe get a 0-0 draw out of this game. But now the fact that they're down 1-0, I think they're going to have to open themselves up, and hopefully that does make this game a little bit better, because like I said, there's only been two real chances that we have seen here in the first half, and hopefully things will pick up here in the second half.
And now it looks like both team is back on the pitch, and I'm also made my way to the student section here on the other side. We're just about to get ready for the start of the second half between the Broncos and the Huskies. Feed this ball here on the left side. It's a dangerous cross in here. He's able to bring down that ball, and now that one is gonna go wide as he's trying to whack that one from outside the box. That being said, that did lead to the opening goal of this game. Oh, and that's a bad pass, and here comes Houston Baptist. This could be an opportunity to tie the game up here, and they have tied the game up as the Husky has equalized here in the 48th minute. And that was just a self-inflicted mistake from the Broncos as they just gave the ball away, and more like that goalkeeper basically just gave possession to the Husky, and the Husky capitalized on that mistake, and they have tied the game up at one apiece. Now the corner deliver in, it's going to be clear the way, but it's going to be a recycle here from the Broncos as this one toward the back post here, and it is going to go wide for a goal kick. Here comes a free kick in a very dangerous area. This one about 24 yards out. Here it is, and it is saved by the keeper there. And well, the keeper does a good job to palm that one away. I think he read that one perfectly there. The corner coming in here. Gonna deliver in, it's toward the back post, and it is gonna be wide as, well, that player had some space there to strike that one on the volley, and unfortunately just could not quite collect it cleanly. Now he does a nice little turn here, and this could be an opportunity, and it's off the post!
So we play 72 minutes into this game as it looks like one of the Houston Baptist player is down on the ground, and that's why the clock is stopped at 72:01. But with 18 minutes left in this game, it is all tied up at one apiece after Houston Baptist got the equalizer just a couple of minutes into the second half. But it was all due to a bad mistake from the Broncos, and their goalkeeper basically just passed it right into one of the Husky player who had a short field to work with, and basically they were able to capitalize on the mistake that the Broncos made. But ever since that equalizer, the Broncos have put a lot of pressure on Houston Baptist. They even hit the post just a couple of seconds ago. So let's see if they can potentially retake the lead here. And remember, if this game remains tied at one apiece, we are going to go to a 2 10-minute extra time period that is going to be sudden death, and the first goal that's going to go in will win the game.
Ooh, that's a high boot, but nothing is given as he's trying to curl this one, and it is gonna go wide there.
Well, it is now 2-1 in favor of the Broncos, as you can see the student section there is definitely celebrating, as what happened there was a through ball that
was able to cut through that Houston Baptist attack or Houston Baptist defense. And that player was able to go through and Goins coolly slots it in to make it a 2-1 lead. And the only thing I'm kind of disappointed after seeing that is that I literally forgot to press the record button. In fact, I actually pressed the wrong button. That was the reason why I didn't get that on film. He's gonna try this one, and it's saved by the keeper. Now they're gonna try to play it over a direct ball, and this could be an opportunity for the Broncos to finish this game off. And that one is gonna go wide there, as it is gonna be a goal kick here. The countdown is on here.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
And that is the full time whistle, full time here at Santa Clara University, as the Broncos is able to win 2-1 over Houston Baptist Huskies. So just finished here at Santa Clara University, as I'm now walked out of the stadium. And in the end, it's the Broncos with a 2-1 win over Houston Baptist Huskies. And overall, I think the Broncos deserved this win because they were really pushing to trying to get that winning goal. And it looked like maybe they weren't going to do so, and they might have to do it in extra time. But with 5 minutes left, they finally got that crucial goal. And I think, you know, the thing that I'm kind of a little bit disappointed after watching that game is the fact that I literally forgot to press the record button to show you that goal, because it was a well-laid work goal where, again, one of their players played a great through ball to send one of their players through on goal, and he coolly slots it in to score the winning goal of this game and get all 3 points for his team. But either way, hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you do, make sure you guys leave a like, smash that subscribe button, and yeah, I of course will see you guys next time for another Sporthop series episode.